This young couple are the ballet dancers Ekaterina Maximova and Vladimir Vasiliev. Every day, long before the stage lights go up, Ekaterina and Vladimir arrive.
We've been dancing together for 27 years on the Bolshoi stage. Of course it helps when you're always together. And not only in the rehearsal studio. If a performer is doing something new, he's always thinking about it, at home, out in the street. Even for an old ballet, you're constantly re-evaluating what you did before.
It's we who have changed. It's not as if we decide, well, I've danced this ballet the same way for 3 years now. It's time for a change. I must change my interpretation. And then after 10 years, make another deliberate change. It's never been that way with me. But Giselle has gradually changed of its own accord.
Katya Maximova herself was scarcely out of the ballet school in 1958 before she was dancing leading roles. Here she prepares for Giselle with her teacher Galina Ulanova, herself a great Giselle from the past.
Here is Galina Ulanova's successor on the stage. Katya Maximova is one of the many who is furthering the fine traditions of the Russian ballet.
It was 25 years ago that Vasiliev and Maximova first danced together in Giselle. This rehearsal is supervised by Ulanova.
In 1964, Vladimir Vasiliev was awarded the Nijinsky Prize as the best dancer. Vasiliev dances in the ballet Laurencia.
Laurencia was choreographed by Shabukin, music by Krein.
Is to penetrate the musical structure of the image, says Vasiliev. While dancing, I feel I'm always singing my role inside of me.
Today, Vasiliev and Maximova still perform together in Giselle. It's a demanding role for the male as well as the female dancer.
Gradually, it became clear to me, not all at once, but gradually, that I must express my attitude to Giselle in my own way, as my own heart dictated, through my own thoughts, and not try to change myself, not try to be someone else. You must be sincere on stage. The audience is always very sensitive to that, especially as I did not have the perfect physical attributes that the marvelous dancers of the past were blessed with.
Moscow, 1986. Again, Giselle. This rehearsal taken by Asaf Mesura. Vasiliev and Maximova are also known in the Bolshoi as strong-minded individualists with their own very positive views about working in such a large company.
In our theatre nowadays, you go off on tour. You're away for 2 or 3 months. You come back and ask, well, what's been happening? And the answer comes back, nothing much, so-and-so's danced Swan Lake, so-and-so Don Quixote. And you say, nothing much, such an event, how did it go? And they answer, all right, she didn't fall over. And what about so-and-so? He didn't fall over either. It's somehow, we're used to looking at things from a different point of view. We're used to each performance being an event. How did he do it? Because each dancer has to do it his way. And as for this, he didn't fall over. We fell over. All the performances differed from each other. The 32 fouettes weren't the point. Of course, we all did them. They were important for all of us. We all worked away at our technique. But the real interest was, what are you dancing it for? And didn't lie in the 32 fouettes themselves. Now there's a new way. 32 fouettes in Swan Lake, 32 here, 32 there, learn the part, don't fall down, and that's it. You're ready to go on. The difference between the parts seems to lie entirely in the fact that you put feathers on your head for one, and a flower behind your ear for the other. I wish there was more of a search for something personal in all this.